guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Eben and this is officially my second video. Big ups to everyone who engaged with my last video. All I wanted to do was just set up my YouTube channel and just get videos running. To my greatest surprise, the feedback I got from my BTS video was crazy. Like, you know, a lot of people found it funny and I'm glad that I created content that people were able to relate with. And I love that you guys were able to connect with my being not so perfect. I thought to do that because the YouTube community always likes to project perfection. And before you get to the point of perfection, there is a process. And that's the process of making mistakes, process of missing your lines and being stupid and being frustrated sometimes. So I thought to show that part that a lot of YouTubers would not necessarily show. But not to worry, if you're here, you're actually at the right place. So viewers' discretion advice. So when I explain stuff, I tend to use my hands a lot, so my gesticulations is like everywhere, so try and ignore the hands and just listen to the story. So this video is going to help you if you're looking to move back to Nigeria or any country in Africa, to be honest. I'm going to be sharing from a perspective of someone who is planning to move back and you are on a budget, or you have a lot of money but you just don't want to spend too much when you move back. But if you've got a lot of money and you don't really have to worry about the amount of money you spend, that's fine. So sit back and just enjoy my story. So this will just be storytelling for you. But for someone who actually needs an advice, I'm like, okay, I'm looking to move back. How do I plan my resources? How do I manage the little that I have for greater impact? So living abroad was such a huge experience for me, from deciding to move abroad, living and working abroad, and then deciding, okay, it's time to move back to Nigeria. The learning curve has been really steep. And I thought there's a lot of experience that I've got that I can use to help people who are looking to move out or who are looking to move back to Nigeria. So I'm going to start with all my experiences from the airport to where I am at now. And I know that there are a lot of young people who were probably born abroad or have lived abroad for the longest part, and they feel like, oh, they need to move back to Nigeria to probably, you know, learn more about their culture, or, you know, come back to family, or just explore career opportunities and probably just change. Because for some people, at some point in your life, you feel like, oh, I'm tired of everybody. I want a new scenery. I want a new experience. And it's perfectly normal. When I left Nigeria a couple of years ago, it was like my life was pretty much okay. But, you know, at some point I was tired. Like, I was just tired of everything. And it's part of growing up. And I just wanted a new scenery. I just wanted to meet new people. I wanted new experiences. I wanted new challenges. And I'm like, okay, you know what? I'm going to move. But while moving, I may as well just do my masters. I don't want to just go abroad and just faff around for a couple of years. I'm like, oh, I'm done exploring. But I thought, I want to go explore, but while at it, I'll probably just get a certification. And yeah, so everything made sense. So I was advancing in my career, I was getting higher certifications, and I was getting the experience and adventure that I need to ensure that my mental health was like spot on. So you may be in that place in your life where you're thinking of, like, you're abroad and you're thinking to move back in Nigeria. So I'm going to guide you through all the necessary things that you need to put into consideration when you're planning to move back to Nigeria or anywhere in Africa. So number one, you need to plan. So if you're opportune to have had 6 months prior to actually plan, it would be great for you to actually save and make sure you have like a lot of money that would sustain you in Nigeria. Because if you're moving back to Nigeria, if your father is not Dangote or Otedola, I'm sorry, like, it may not really be easy getting a job. So you need to just, you know, take the last few months and plan, save as much as you can, and just move back to your home country. So the first thing you need to, save a lot of money so that when you're moving back, you have a lot of money to sustain you, so that you're not relying on family and friends before you get a good job. Station is a very big deal. When you're moving back, you don't want to not plan for your transport, to be honest, because if you want to do Uber, you're going to spend a lot more if you choose to do Uber. I think when I moved back, before I got my car, it took a couple of weeks, but I remember transferring like 200,000 to an account, and I think in 1 month everything was off, because, like, you know, Uber just charges you 1.5, 1.5, 1.5. When you're moving back, like, you don't just stay at a place. Like, you're moving, you're trying to connect with friends, connect with people, trying to get things rolling again. There's a lot of movement that needs to be done, so you need to plan for your travel. If you have money to buy a car, it's best to buy a car so that you're able to move around and you know, go to do all the things. For the public transport, it may be a bit difficult for you to adapt to Nigeria's public transport system because it's not the metro bus, sorry. So it's best to buy a car or use an Uber, because if you choose to do the public transport, as a London or American boy, my friend, it may be difficult. It's like Nigerian bus is a bit choked up. You don't get the convenience that you get abroad. I believe you should already know that. But if you don't mind public transport, by all means, it will save you a lot of money. You probably won't spend so much, but you'll be able to get to all the places. Maybe with a lot more hassle, but if you don't mind it, why not? Go ahead. Way to go. When you're moving back, it's very important that you pay attention to the differences in culture, because you're moving back to a country where people do not mind their business. In fact, it is their life mission to know what's going on in your life and be part of your life. So you may have to now, you know, but may have to find the balance so that you're not so out of place, because if you're out of place, you'll probably be alone and you don't want to be alone, to be honest. My world started from the airport when I was moving back to Nigeria. I remember, I don't know, what's that airline? I think it was Turkish Airline. And so I did a stopover. There's one that goes from Heathrow to Turkey. And from Turkey, you can now see the actual Nigerian plane, the one that moves from Turkey to Nigeria. Those are the ones that are usually like, the aircrafts are usually like older. There's usually a lot more people, you know, and all of that. Well, you guys know what I'm talking about for stopover flights, if you do stopovers. So I remember just like, I had my shades on because like it was sunny and I was weak. I was tired the day before. I had to do a lot of parking and I was moving. So it was really, really stressful. So I had my shades on because I looked like a mess. So I just like covered my eyes. I didn't want anyone to see like my eye bags and all of that. And then it was quite sunny, so I just wanted to shades. And even if I wanted to just do fashion or wear my shades, I just wanted to wear shades, to be honest. So when I was walking, I was on the aisle, so I see this couple, probably in their 50s, mid or late 50s. You know, they were sitting on the front row. They were sitting on the front row. And then they looked at me and they were like, "Look at this man, you are wearing shades inside the aeroplane. Look at this youth of today. Wearing shades in the plane." Do you know that look that older people give when they see stupid teenagers? That's the look they had on their face. It's like, I'm like, guys, I'm standing here. They were literally talking about me. I was walking past. I wanted to stop and say, "Guys, like, you know, it's a British thing. Like, guys, why are you looking at me? Why are you staring at me?" But I'm like, before they beat me in this plane, nobody will even support me. Now Nigeria is like, if you go and talk, everybody in the plane, it's not one of those viral videos you've seen of people fighting in the plane. I shamefully, I just went to my seat with my shades. I'm like, what did I do wrong? Like, I just wore shades and I was living my life. Plane that I paid for with my money. I don't know these guys from anywhere. If I was 15 years old, that's probably different. Maybe like, okay, like maybe he's a teenager and maybe we need to nudge him in the right direction. This fool just saw me and wanted to talk me down in the presence of everybody. I felt embarrassed, but I'm like, oh my God, these are Nigerians. I'm like, "Iben, are you really sure you want to do this moving back thingy?" And then he dawned on me, "Iben, you're moving back to Nigeria, the country where people do not mind their business." So it was a hard pill for me to swallow, but then it was too late to change my mind because I was already on the plane back to Lagos. People are literally living your life for you, or people try to live your life for you. And then in Nigeria, it's a culture. Other people feel like it's okay to talk to younger people in a demeaning way. And if you're going to get angry about it all the time, to be honest, you'd lose your mind and you'd end up being tagged as disrespectful. So when things like this happen, you just like, that's fine, move on, to be honest. You don't want to get into a fight with older people in public. So you need to get ready for all that. If you are my kind of person, like, it will be different. Like, navigating the cultures will be really, really different. I'm saying this because you've probably not been to Nigeria before, or you have been away for a while and a lot of things have changed. So you have to make a conscious effort to align back to the culture. So on cost of living, what I've noticed is that, like, so when you move back, there's a tendency for you to overspend in the sense that you're used to the good life. A lot of things you would want, your cravings, your fashion sense, everything, it's gonna be more expensive in Nigeria. So in terms of your cost of living, for example, if you want to get a pack of bacon at ShopRite, in the UK, you can get a pack of bacon for £3.50 or $5 or $4, like, for a pack. But in Nigeria, you're looking at, say, 3,900 to 4,000 naira as ShopRite. So you want to be buying a pack of bacon for 4,000 naira. That's actually quite a lot of money for processed meat, you get. So most of the things you've been used to, most of the kind of foods you've been used to eating, it may be more expensive. That's why a lot of Nigerians like to patronize open markets. I advise that you patronize for food, patronize open markets and buy some of the things you can get. And then for some of those toiletries and all of that that you'd only get at the bigger supermarkets, you can try and get those ones there, and then the rest you can get open markets. Trust me, you'll be saving a lot of money. There are a lot of online platforms that you can actually shop for groceries online, etc. Shopping online will save you a whole lot. It will save you money, it will save you time, etc. So just do that and get it. And in terms of like eating out in Nigeria, to be honest, is quite different. In Nigeria, people don't fine dine like that. To fine dining, unless you have too much money, fine dining is what is planned, strategic. You have to plan fine dining. You don't just show up and be like, oh my god, I want to find that money out in the evening. Well, except your hotel dollar or Dangote. So you need to plan it. So fine dining is planned. Fine dining in Nigeria is what? For meetings, important meetings, meetings with people you value, you care about. You can't just be doing all your lunches like. And then fine dining is not that cheap in Nigeria. Fine dining should be, as in, it's an occasion. I want to fine dine. If you come back with that, if you come back with that mentality, and then you want to now start fine dining around, you go to Oki Bistro today, tomorrow you go to Backyard Lagos, next tomorrow you go to Shiro, next day you go to Owe, next tomorrow you go to Yellow Chili, next tomorrow you go to Ocean Basket. Well done, sir. Well done. I'm proud of you. I love you. Go ball. You're gonna be broke. That's you're gonna be broke so fast. And then you don't even know that you're going to get the job. Now come back and your friends are carrying you. They are going to... But of course, unless you are rich and you have a lot of money, you can choose to eat in different restaurants. Backyard today, Shiro tomorrow, and all of that. You can choose to do that if you have a lot of money. But if you're on a budget and you're trying not to spend too much, fine dining is usually planned. So it's like for one meal, you'll be looking at, say, 15,000, 20,000 for the more high-end ones. So you don't want to be doing that, because I don't know how much you want to be earning in Nigeria that for one meal you'll be paying, unless of course you have money. If you have money, you're out of these conversations. By all means, Nigeria is a great place. There's a lot of restaurants you can explore, you know. There's a lot of restaurants you can explore. Like, if you have the money, Nigeria knows how to help you spend it even more than abroad. Like, there's a lot, there are beaches, there are what, there's everything you can do in Nigeria to spend your money. And Nigeria just has a way of, you know, taking it. So if you have your money, why not? By all means, explore everything. But if you are on a budget and if you're not sure as to when you're going to get a job, it's very important that you try and reduce the number of times you eat out. As an option, you can always get like good takeaway shops where you can get like good food and their hygiene level is amazing. So you can always get that. So those kind of places, they make good food, so you can always just eat there. And then when you want to fine dine, if it's more of a special location or you're looking to treat yourself, then you can just do that. So in Nigeria, when it comes to accommodation, like, so a lot of people do not pay attention to detail when building their houses, to be honest, particularly houses for public rent. So if you're looking to rent a place when you move back, it may not be really easy unless you're moving to places like the island in Lagos or Abuja or some other cities. If you're going to live in places like Lagos mainland, to be honest, you'd have to spend a lot more time house hunting. And so I think you need to factor that when planning to come back. So if you have family, it's best to stay with them and settle down. When you settle, you're able to find a place. My family lives in Lagos, so I stayed with my family for I think a month and a half. So you want to make sure that when you're coming back, you have a soft landing. Stay with your parents for as much as you can. Stay with your friends or whatever for as much as you can. And then you're able to, you know, go through places. You're able to choose good agent and actually house hunt by yourself so that you get the quality of what you're looking for. When it comes to house hunting, a lot of people always end with regrets because agents in Nigeria will sell you. In fact, that's a story for another day. Because my house hunting experience was such a movie. At some point I got frustrated. I'm like, you know what, I'm just gonna keep staying with my parents. So it's not as easy to get a place even when you have the money. And if you have an eye for quality, it may be difficult for you to actually find a place. So it's not something you want to do in a haste. It's good to take your time, get a place for soft landing, and then gradually find a place that suits. Also, when you move back, you need to brace up for job interviews. You need to brace up for job interviews. Like, job interviews are not so easy. I know how people feel like. I know how people who are moving back, they feel like when they move back, they're going to come and job interview. That when people see you, when you give them accent, they'll give you the job and say like, this is for you. Honey, it doesn't work like that. Trust. There's a lot of, like, the pool of talent in Nigeria is crazy. There's a lot of smart people, young people, who even know more than you know. You're moving back with all that technology, with all that pro technology you've been exposed to abroad. Trust me, there's a lot of people who know way more than you. Trust me. Trust me. So you have to do more than a great accent to get a job. Trust me. You have to understand the Nigerian market. You have to understand how these things work. You have to understand how employment is done here, because employment is very different. In the UK, if you want to get a job, they are very keen on experience. They are very keen on, have you done this before? Once you tell them you've done this before, they want to listen to you. Like, they want to give you the job. They want to consider you. But in Nigeria, experience is good though. You need to be able to sell yourself. You need to be able to know somebody. You need to be able to just be Nigerian, if that makes sense. I feel like Nigerian employers are more interested in you and the special spice that you bring to their job. But abroad, they're more interested in, have you done this before? What wealth of experience are you bringing to this role? It's good to understand these little things. Well, I'm not in HR, so I can't advise, but it's good to understand what the typical Nigerian employer is looking for and see how you can apply yourself into that so that you can easily get a job. Because I know a lot of people who, they moved back 1 year, 2 years, they didn't get a job. So you want to check that you have that covered. Have great friends around. Friends who are going to show you around. Friends who are going to tell you what's applicable now in the country, because you've obviously been away for it. I didn't have friends who really told me all of that, because I felt like I knew Lagos. So, and that was not bad, because I'd been away for a while. And I remember, like, you know, I drove through some road that I was not supposed to drive through, and then I got robbed. I was not supposed to drive through the road at a particular time, and then I got robbed. My phone was stolen, money was stolen, I was beaten. That's a story for another day. But it's good to have friends who will just advise you on, you know, what's applicable in the city at the time, particularly in a city like Lagos where it's hot. You have to know these things. Okay guys, I hope you've been able to learn one or two things from these stories I've shared, to be honest. Like, moving back is never an easy decision, and I know it takes people a lot of time, like people several years, even people who are older, when they want to move back, they spend time thinking about how long and all of that. So I hope I was of help to you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please click on the subscribe button now.